Hey everyone, Rick here, and folks, welcome back to another unit review for Battlefields of Mana. This time, we're back with Mercenaries. Mercenaries are fantastic. This time we have Border Guards. So what makes Mercenaries fantastic in Battlefields of Mana? Well, first of all, unlike units, you know, from Lunar Knights or Regal Guard or even the Marauders themselves, you can have up to four of each unit type, but Mercenaries, number one, you have to earn the right to even include them in your army. And number two, you can only include one of any given mercenary unit or single figure in your army. So what do I mean when I say you have to earn it? Well, check out my video overview on the Bard. I kind of go into more detail there, but essentially, in order to be able to use this unit of border guards, for example, in your army, you first have to defeat them. Find an opponent, they'll put together a marauder army, include the mercenary unit you want to eventually include in yours, and then you create your army of Regal Guard or Lunar Knights or whatever, and then you have to beat your opponent, and then from then on you'll be able to, if you want, include that mercenary unit you beat in your army. So for example, border guards. So when your opponent is using them in the marauder army, they will have a marauder banner bearer, for example. But once you've beaten them and earned the right to use them yourself, you may, if you're a Regal Guard fan, have a Regal Guard generic banner bearer in there. So why might you want border guards in the future? Well, let's take a look at what they offer. Attack dice, too. So every figure in close combat provides two attack dice each. Combat strength is a plus one. So not only are they rolling two dice per figure, but every die they roll is automatically increased one value to a maximum of six. Armor two, so that means only threes or better will hit them when they are being attacked. No defensive special abilities, no range. They do have the typical cavalry movement of 6 inches, so they can either move up to 6 inches and then still engage in combat, or they can forego combat, move twice, and move up to 12 inches. And then look at this, initiative bonus of plus three. So when they are in close combat and you're determining who goes first, roll off. D6 roll off with your opponent. Border guards will get to add three to the result of that die. And that can exceed six for initiative rolls. Initiative rolls can exceed six and go below zero. Health, two. So every figure in the unit has two health points, which means every two wounds the unit takes, boom. That'll be a casualty removed. Now look at these abilities. This is where the border guards really shine. They have nimble. I think they're the only unit in the entire game that has nimble and a combat strength bonus. So they are a heavy hitting but fast unit. So what is nimble? Well, nimble, if you recall, allows the unit to move an extra time for free. So normally, like we said, you move six and attack, or move six twice. With nimble, you get an extra optional 6 inches of movement. So you can move up to 18 inches, move three times, or move twice, move up to 12 inches, and still engage in a combat action. So they can move a foot. And don't forget, a battlefield in Battlefields of Mana is typically 2 by 2 feet. So that's half the board they can move and still engage in a close combat action. And then the next ability, collision. So if they move into contact with an opponent, doesn't matter if they're going to fight this turn or not, doesn't matter if they moved all 18 inches, they still get collision hits, which is a D6. As soon as they move into contact with an opponent, they don't get it if an opponent moves into contact with them, but if they move into contact with an opponent, roll a D6, they get that many unmodified attacks right then and there during the movement phase. Now again, unmodified, so they're not going to be plus one like a normal attack, but they will still get up to six potential unmodified attacks just for moving into contact. And then lastly, of course, the cavalry special ability, which gives them an additional plus one to their initiative bonus if they are facing off against non-polearm infantry. So again, if they are up against cavalry, they won't get the bonus. If they're up against spearmen or halberdiers, any kind of polearm infantry, they won't get the cavalry ability. But if they're up against axemen or archers or swordsmen or men-at-arms or what have you, they will get an additional plus one to their initiative bonus. It goes from a plus three to a plus four. Now, how much does all this cost? 4 points. It costs 4 points to include a unit of border guards to your army. Typically, mercenary units are a little bit more bang for your buck than a typical unit because you are limited to only one of that unit type. And, of course, you had to have earned the right to include this mercenary unit of border guards in your army. All right, folks, that is going to be it for this unit review of border guards for Battlefields of Mana. Thank you all so much for watching. I do truly appreciate it. And until next time.